Hey everybody, this is Marcus Crawford with the Idaho Quadcopter Channel. Hey, as promised, I have the Mavic Air 2. This is the first flight, and I'm out at the Snake River Canyon. So we're gonna put this baby up in the air for its first flight, and we're just gonna send it out over the canyon. This guy is everything that I had hoped it to be, or at least it seems to be so far. Very robust drone, reminds me a lot of my Mavic 2 Zoom, except for a little different shape of the camera and so forth, and it's smaller and lighter. It's fairly windy today. I think UAV forecast said like 9 mph winds with 13 mph gusts. It's all of that. Okay, so I had to tie up the strap on my Canon camera because the wind was whipping it around, and I'm sure that'd make a lot of noise. But in any case, the Mavic Air 2, so it gets kind of confusing because it's the Mavic 2 Zoom or the Mavic 2 Pro, but it's the Mavic Air 2. So anyway, I always get confused, but I'm old. But anyway, we're going to take this guy up in the air. And oh, I see a couple of stickers that I forgot to take off of the back of the arms here. So we're going to get those off of there. I thought I got all the stickers. There's a ton of stickers on these things. See that sticker on the back of the arm there? So we'll get that off. But then we're going to take it out and send it over the canyon. Last night, I fired it up and did all of the calibrations, etc. Did an IMU calibration, a gimbal calibration, and of course, a compass calibration. But then again, because the last time it was calibrated was in China, so we're going to calibrate it again out here, and we are right on the very edge of the canyon where I'm standing right now. So we'll get it calibrated, and you'll see the battery is probably at about 80% or so, because it is the battery I use for all the updates. But we'll use that one just to send it out over the canyon and get a little bit of video. I will shoot in 4K 30 frames per second. No point in doing 60 frames per second because it's not like we're going to be doing any slow motion anything. And then we may or may not try some HDR. So let's get it up in the air and we'll try out some stuff. Okay, so I have the drone fired up. I have the controller fired up and the app fired up, and it says takeoff permitted. But before we do that, we are going to go look at the camera settings, and it already is in video mode. So let me go into the click on the film strip. You can see it's in video, 30 frames per second, 4K, and we're in normal. So we may try some HDR this flight as well. It's kind of a partly cloudy day, so you know, not a lot of sun. Wow, I just saw a big raptor, big eagle fly up behind me here. So this is the birds of prey area. And I'm not kidding you, he was literally 20 feet the other side of me there. And he had something in his mouth. It looked like maybe a little, one of the little whistle pigs out here, a little squirrel. But anyway, it was kind of cool to see. He was a big bird. But anyway, 30 frames per second. And so then the other thing we want to do is it says takeoff permitted at the top, but I'm going to click on that, and it's going to give us a status. And you can see that I have our return to home altitude set at 60 meters. Pre-flight check says normal, but let's go into that because we want to, well, no, maybe I, yeah, so I probably have to go into, I made a mistake, I have to go into the other menu, because I, no matter what, it says normal, but I want to, under safety here, I want to calibrate the compass. And you can see there, it says compass normal, but we're going to click calibrate. And Sarah's going to help me hold the controller while I do it here. So I'm going to click start. And we're rotating horizontally and then vertically. Head up, it says, and it gives us a successful calibration. So I did that because it's the first time I've flown it in this area. I calibrated it at home, and I know people tell you don't calibrate at home, but I did, just because the last time it was calibrated was was in China, and then we recalibrated it here. So honestly, at this point, I see no reason not to take off. I'm going to start recording now. And then what we're going to do initially is we're going to go up in the air. We're going to test return to home, make sure that the return to home is working correctly. And then once we know that that's good, we're going to send it out over the canyon. So I'm going to do an auto takeoff on the app right here. And it's the same as the Mavic Mini. Hold my finger over that. And sorry, I didn't have the camera down, tilted quite down enough. We're gonna let it hover there for a second so that it knows where it's, and you can hear the obstacle avoidance beeping there because it knows it's close to us. Okay, so I think it's seen its landing spot pretty good here. We're gonna go straight up. So you can see where we're at here. We're right on the edge of the canyon. And let's, we're gonna go out. We're not gonna go over the canyon first. We're gonna go out a little ways. And boy, like everybody else has reported, that yaw is fairly touchy in normal mode. So let's send it out. So we'll go out about 100 meters or so. That's pretty close, 90 meters. So we are going to now hit return to home, and I'm going to do that on the controller right here. And it's turning around and it's coming back to us. And boy, is it moving. Yeah, maybe not as fast as I thought, 3 meters per second. Oh no, there we go. That was going up. I'm sorry. 10 meters per second. It was ascending. I was looking at the wrong calculation there. So let's try the function here and see if we can get that camera. I've got it set to point the camera down. I'm going to push it once. And there we go. You can see it reorient itself. And I'm telling you, it is spot on. It is spot on the, let's just go ahead for the fun of it. Let's let it land. Because it looks to be, well, now it moved off a little bit. Let's see if it catches it. If it doesn't catch it, I will, I'll abort the landing. If it doesn't hit the, it's pretty damn close. Look at that. It's going to hit it right on the mark. It is so close. And it picked up the camera there automatically, did that itself. Now that's what I call precision landing. It's just a little bit off the middle of the H there. how cool is that? Okay, so we know return to home works. So we're gonna take off again and we're gonna send it out over the canyon. That's DJI precision landing for you. So let's take off again. So we'll give it a second over the landing pad, let those downward facing sensors get a good look at its landing zone. And let's slowly go up a little bit. So we're up about 8.5 meters high. Guys, I don't think there's anything left to do here but send it. I'm gonna drop the gimbal just a little bit here. We're gonna get that rule of thirds. And again, we're shooting in 4K, 30 frames per second. Okay, so it looks like we may be blown out a little bit in the sky, but I'm gonna leave everything on automatic this first flight. We've got clouds over the canyon and everything, so this would be a good test. So we're gonna go full stick forward now. And this is in normal mode. And over the edge of the canyon we go. and we're at about 8 meters per second or so. Wind has died down here all of a sudden, which is good. Boy, what a beautiful day. Good solid connection. On the FPV here, we see a little bit of zebra stripe in the clouds, so that's a little bit blown out. But if you look at the graph there, the histogram, we look like we got the mountain right in the middle, which is right where you want it. So we're coming up on half a kilometer. I'm just holding that stick forward, folks. I promised you I would send it, and I'm sending it. .600 meters. We'll go out a full kilometer, and it's about 8 meters per second, so gosh, that's about roughly 20, 21 miles an hour, something like that. Yeah, now we picked up a little speed. Must have got the wind in its back there. And we are right over the top of the river. And we are closing in on a kilometer. Well, I've got a little, the sun is reflecting on my screen, so we're over a kilometer now, and we've had good solid FPV, but let's slow it down and stop right there, and I'm going to turn around and I'm going to see if I can get a decent yaw here. Everybody has complained about how touchy the yaw controls are on this thing, and they are a little bit, so I'm not sure, but I thought I saw that there's no adjustment either, so we'll have to figure that out. Anyway, so we're back facing, this is probably now facing essentially south. We'll drop the gimbal just a little bit, and let's, for the fun of it, let's throw it into sport mode now. And again, we're shooting at 4K 60. Let's go full stick forward. And I noticed the obstacle avoidance says it's disabled, so they must be disabled in sport mode. But we're moving right along there at about 18 meters per second, so it is getting with the program. And it's got the wind at its back, so that's probably helping it, or at least near as I can tell, the wind is in its back. And so where we're facing here, we're off to the left. Boy, this canyon is beautiful, and this is the time of year when there's still some green. Yeah, so it's past us already, because you can see the distance starting to increase again. So it's past us where we're at on the side. So we'll go down here a ways. Where are we at on battery? Boy, DJI, if you could help us with that color at the top, I can barely see that. Looks like 54% or something. DJI really needs to change that color at the top there. So off in the distance there, that is the Swan Falls Dam you see. Okay, so I'm going to get some altitude here, and we are going to go back over the side of the canyon. And that's me yawing it around here. I just want to make sure we clear the side of the canyon, and it looks like we're good. So evidently in sport mode it does disable obstacle avoidance, because I see red on both of those. Yeah, so we're at max altitude. Whoops, sorry about that quick yaw. So there we are. This, I believe, what we're looking at in the kind of the center of the screen here, let me see if I can center on it, and I'll see if I can drop the camera down, gimbal down as we go. That is, I think the Boy Scouts made that, but I think it started out is when they used to have airmail, and it would point the airmail planes the direction they needed to go. Pick the camera back up here, and we are coming up on dedication point. So right over here, I'm going to slow down a little bit. We're going to go back into normal mode and slow it down just a little, and let's drop some altitude so you can see what we're doing. And right, I'm gonna center the camera on it right now. That is dedication point, and that's where often you see me filming. We moved up the hill because there were some people there that were they were looking at the birds, and I can appreciate that, you know, they don't want the noise of a drone when they're trying to bird watch and so forth. So we moved on up the hill, and I'll show you where we're at. But that is dedication point, and if you are ever in this area, I recommend you stop there. That is really fun. You can see, they put a rock wall there, and you can look right over the edge of the canyon, and there's a lot of raptors over here. If you're a bird watcher, I'm telling you, it's really something to see. So I recommend that. So let me pick the camera back up. And we will come back to where Sarah and I are at. So you can see this trail off in the distance. That's what we walked up to get here. And like I said, there were some other people out here hiking, and we didn't want to bother them. But they hiked. It's interesting. They came hiking up the same trail we were. And so I told them, I said, hey, we didn't want to bother you watching birds. And they were really nice. They said, oh, God, no problem. And they were interested in the drone, etc. So it was pretty cool. Hear the drone. Okay, I'm going to drop some altitude here. That's me. And there's the canyon again. Okay, we are down to 27% battery. Going this direction, yeah, it's going against the wind. So maybe we'll just go out a ways. I better raise some altitude. again, because I want to make sure if we do come over the top of the canyon, we clear everything. And I see that the obstacle avoidance sensors are back on. Yeah, so I thought I saw something. I had my histogram in the way and I couldn't see what that message said. I thought it said something about return to home. But that's me yawing around here. And this will be good seeing what the, with the cloud cover there. I'm anxious to see how this video turns out. Okay, so we're gonna hear some beeping. I'm gonna hit return to home and let's try for another precision landing and see how it does. Hitting return to home. I'm gonna do it on the app this time. And yeah, we want return to home. So here she comes. We're about 400 meters out. I'd say battery is pretty good. I didn't look at where we started there, but I think it was about 80% battery, or maybe a little over 80%. I've used quite a bit of battery doing the updates, and we've been had video on the whole time for almost 17 minutes now, so I'd say that's pretty good. So I'm thinking with a full battery, you're probably easily going to get to 25 minutes or so. And here it comes. I'm watching the drone up above me there, and I'm going to get out of the way so you guys can see it hit the landing pad here. I'm going to hit that function button and we'll drop the camera down so you can get a peek of that. So it's a little bit off, but we'll see if it finds it as it gets closer. Sorry about those messages on my phone there. Yeah, so we're a little bit off. Let's see if it finds it. I'm gonna cancel it if it doesn't find it. Oh, look at that. Oh, ye of little faith. Look at that. It's right over the top. Oh yeah, it's got it. Oh, this thing is so cool. So it picked up the camera, does that automatically. Yeah, it's gonna nail it here. I mean, look at that. That is right in the middle of the H. Oh man, that is awesome. We have 17% battery left. So I'm gonna stop recording. And so that's our first flight with the Mavic Air 2. It certainly lived up to my expectations, I can tell you that. The thing just performed perfectly and handled really well, like I said, and others have said this too. The yaw is a little bit quick, so we need to get that figured out. I did not, however, put it in tripod mode. Actually, that's probably the answer. When you're trying to do a yaw like that, just slip it into tripod mode real quick, and that'd probably be the way to do that. Enjoy the canyon, and I'll see if I can find some decent music to put with this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. I guess that's about it. This is Marcus Crawford with the Idaho Quadcopter Channel out. And if you like this kind of content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Most of all, I really appreciate you checking out this video, and we absolutely will see you on the next one. Bye now.